Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, y'all. Ira Epstein of Lynn & Associates with your agriculture update for this Monday, the 8th of January, 2017, just after 2:10 p.m. Central Standard Time. The markets, especially the grain markets, are going to start focusing on Friday's important USDA reports. We're getting an idea of what the end of the year is going to look like. World supplies, U.S. supplies on hand, all kinds of adjustments that come in. It's a big report. And you get, of course, wheat acreage at this time of the year, which is going to be something else looked at. Did we see any damage to our winter wheat is going to be a question that traders ask themselves. But right now, with wheat down 3 cents, it doesn't appear so. And remember, it just went through absolute freezing weather without a lot of snow cover. But it's early. It's a little early to tell if that could happen yet. Beans and corn, still down. Worries about what South American crops are going to look like. Then what are we going to shift around and plant? Weather changes, that impacted the cattle market today as it got warmer. And in fact, you even look at natural gas, unable to do very much right now, as the Chicago area, for example, is going to go into the 50s this week. That weather will move east, and that gives you a small band of warmth. But right behind it, folks, come Saturday or so, we go back down into the 20s, and then you got to look for beyond 14 days to see what happens. But we are going to get a small break in this weather, and that is important. Now, when I take a look at the soybean chart, you still have a pattern where you've been gradually slipping down. You bounced from the 949 and a half area, but you're not far from that. You're still 958 and a quarter, and these are on a closing basis on a weekly chart. For the week, it's the first day of the week, so we're down 3 cents. When you look at a daily area chart of closes, all that happened is we had a nice rally up that did get through a last rally, but it ran into resistance literally against the 18-day moving average of closes, and that stopped the market on this rally. When we take a look at a regular bar chart, you can see the action that's all involved here. And you see it clear when you put the swing line study on, because it does have a pattern of higher lows and higher highs. You break that pattern if you take out 959 and a quarter. Now, if we look at where the market rallied up to, you could see on Friday it got up to and through that 18-day average and then thrown right on back. And so often I tell you that if you're above the 18-day average, look for support on the first challenge of it. If you're under it, look for that area. Does that work all the time? Nothing works all the time. But what you're looking for in charts are the probabilities, and that's all that you can say the charts are. You try to read them in a way, and that's what I teach in my charting course to help you best understand what to expect. So we had, I'll call this rally a contra trend rally, because you had been in a big downtrend. You have not been able to close over the 18-day average. That keeps the bias to the downside. In terms of where the Bollinger Bands are, which is an algorithm designed to give you an idea of resistance and support zones, they are rushing in on the market. Notice how the bottom band, the black dash band, keeps shooting up and the top band is falling down. A market will trade within those bands 95% of the time. So when you get up to the top band, look for resistance points. When you get down to the band, look for initial support points. So if you were to break from here, maybe the 51 and 3 quarter area is going to offer support. The problem is you would then be taking out 59 and a quarter, and again, you'd have no shot at a trend. Right now, what you have a shot at is if prices don't take out 59 and a quarter and close over 69 and a half, you'd have higher lows, higher highs, upside bias, because you'd be over that 18-day average. What you have right now is nothing. You have the swing line up, but the bias down. The two counter each other. And all I can say about slow stochastics is momentum is pointing up. Hasn't turned down yet. So the pullback may be just that temporarily, no more than a pullback. In soybean oil, it's pretty clear to see what the market's done. It had what we call an embedded reading, and that's when the slow stochastic, both numbers that make it up, the red and the blue, people call them a K and a D line, got back over 20, and when that occurs, often, I'm not using the word always, often, price and the 18-day average of closes right here make a run at each other. You did that, Friday you were there, and today you pulled right back to the support level at the 100-day average of closes and then bounced back and closed over the 18-day average. Now, if this market were to get over Friday's highs, and this is the meal market, you could say that the next objective might be the upper Bollinger Band resistance. I don't know if it'll happen or not, but right now the bias is up, there is no trend, and momentum is trying to move higher, as you can see right there. In the soybean oil market, you've gone from lower Bollinger Bands all of a sudden to an upper Bollinger Band, and you really hadn't done that until right here at the end of October. So the market has sort of saying that maybe it's reached an area here in this 3270s that is cheap enough. That doesn't mean the trend is ready to move to the upside because you're not trending. You have the lower and low and a higher high. That's not a trend. You're overbought. Momentum is trying to turn down, and prices have already returned to what I call that line in the sand area, that neutral area, the 18-day average of closes. In the corn market, the market broke out today again to a downtrend. You've now got the lower highs, the lower lows. If I back up, and you can see this as of Friday, you really had a pattern of a higher low, a higher high. But momentum was turning down, and if you took out the 350 level, you break through that, and maybe you could make a run at the lower Bollinger Band. That seems to be what's going on. Momentum's giving you a strong indicator that prices want to work lower. In the wheat market, it's the opposite. First, you're overbought and correcting an overbought condition. Even if you were to take out the last break low of 424, you'd have a higher low pattern. Got this right there? If you break through that, you'd have the lower low and a higher high. I said that backwards. Support, the 18-day average of closes, but with momentum down, I think traders are backing away from that market. In the sugar market, today really took the market by storm. Now, you did lose the embedded reading. I want to show you this. The only time you can get it back is the very next day. So if this market doesn't get it back, the odds are the market's going to lay down a bit. The problem is, and there is a problem, it's already hit its downside targets and found great support at the 1459 and 56 level. Again, when you lose an embedded reading, the idea is price will make a run towards the closest of the major averages. In this case, it hit both of them and found excellent support and bounced away. Is it in the top part of the day's range? Not completely, but not too far from it either. It'll be an interesting day tomorrow. In the coffee market, momentum pointing down. You've got the pattern now in place, and I'll show you this. This was Friday's pattern. You still had the higher lows, higher highs. But if you take out 126.60, you break that and you put the lower high, lower low pattern in, and with that, I would expect the challenge of the 18-day average in the market to go back to neutral, figuring out or trying to figure out what to do next. Where did this market fail on the rally? Look at the upper Bollinger Band and the 100-day average of closes, the first challenge. So the bulls probably got themselves into that area, took notice of it, and may have backed off. In the cocoa market, you have a higher high, a lower low. Do you see how flat these Bollinger Bands are now going? You have a market that's void of a real trend. It's just spinning around now in here. Even momentum is going flat, but it is in overbought territory. Any reading over 70, I think, is overbought. When we go to the cotton market, it's lost its embedded reading, and it's confirmed it's lost. You can only get it back the next day, like I said, in sugar. Well, you got 2 days of it lost. But each time it's done this, on the past three times since December, it has not been able to get to the 18-day average. That's highly, highly unusual. So keep your eye on that. When you don't do it, until it happens again, give the benefit to the doubt that it may not happen. Let's assume it does happen. So what? All you do is go back to the 18-day average. Do you have a trend here? This market has moved most of this way up without higher highs and higher lows. It's been a son of a gun market. In the cattle market, I wish I could tell you I'm surprised, but I was telling you, as soon as the warmer weather comes in, they're going to start moving cattle back to the plants that need them, out of the feedlots. It costs too much money to keep feeding them in the cold weather. You got to move them. And they moved them, and the market went to the lower Bollinger Band, and this is a weather play. You took the feeder cattle down sharply into this previous low, so from a higher high to a lower low, there's nothing you can do there. If you try to be a weatherman trading markets, you will generally not do a very good job of it. In the hog market, you've got a pattern here. If we take a look at the slow stochastic, both numbers over 80, but not the day before the day before. You're overbought, trying to get up to a resistance point. Still a strong market, has shown no signs of trying to break out of that strength that it's been displaying for quite a while. You know, I talk about all this and I do my very best to my subscribers as I teach them different charting methods. I start them off in the morning with buy and sell recommendations. I review 40 charts very specific with the best trading ideas I can come up with. And if you haven't seen it, I'd love to show it to you. Now, people ask, what does it cost? It runs $60 a month. So basically, it's about $2.50 a day for my research. And believe me, you don't get one letter. You get a minimum of two. You get oral updates if you're in the North American continent here. You get my videos. You get a heck of a lot. It's a great package for not a lot of money. And you can either commit month to month, let it roll over. And it's not monthly. The day you start, it goes another 30 days, and then it renews itself. Or you just tell us, I don't want it to renew. End of discussion. But if you haven't tried it, take a look at it. Either go to our website, sign up for it. You can call my staff. You can work with it that way. You can come up here. If you're watching me on YouTube, you'll see this icon. Click it. It'll take you right to that page. Or underneath us in many websites, it says, click here for Ira's free information. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I will talk to you all tomorrow. Take care now.